Reviews with me, Terry Kay, doing a quick one if I can. I've got a set of badges. I've got Golden Champion and Golden Glory. I think I'm going to go with the Golden Glory first. It's pointless doing one against the other because there's no correlation between the two. They're different beers, different types of beers and all that. Right, so Badger. Golden Glory. Not sure if we're talking of. I seem to remember one of these having honey in them or something. It doesn't say. So let's crash away and get going. Get it open. Do a quick one. Bang away. Here's the golden. Here we go. Smoke. I bet you any money you like. It's clear glass, but I've looked after it. I bet ya, not an ounce of skunk. I'm sorry, I know I keep on about it, but I've looked after it. I've took care of it. It's clear. It's beautiful. You can see that beauty here. It's clear. Not an ounce of skunk. Brewed in Badger Dorset. Brewed in Dorset. Let's crash away. Lovely little sort of etching on the glass. I love that. Love this sort of stuff around here. Nice. Why are you spending that on glass stuff? We've got 500 mil. If you're spending out on glass and getting your own glasses made, you could quite easily have had a 560 size one. Why not? You know, go against the grain. Go British. All right. You know, so they've been going since 1777. You know what I mean? So, really, they should kind of, you know, stick to the Imperial a little bit. Make a statement. Come on, brewers. Make a statement, especially the big brewers. Adnams, Badgers, Green King, you know, Harveston, you know, Fuller's. You should all make a statement and produce 568 mil bottles. I know we'll probably end up doing it, and it's like the McLager companies do it, you know, but I'd be probably Wells and Young or someone like that, with all their British bus that I've tried to scrape off and that. Anyway, I do digress. That's what it looks like. That's the head. I don't think that's being helped along by any unfair means and that. It looks quite natural. Usually if you've got these E405 heads with the big brewers, it looks more meringue-y, you know. You've only got to look at the top of a Bombardier, you know. Big meringue head on it, it ain't going to die for another 200 years. It's got a 200 year like half-life. So, let's have a smell. Quite a pleasant smell. Like a peachy tangerine cordial or chew sweet or something like that. It's smelling almost unreal, almost as if you've had a little bit of cordial in there. I ain't saying they are, you know. But that's rich if it's coming off of hops alone, you know, hops and malts alone. That's rich, it really is. But I kind of like it. I think it's nice. I don't think they're adding like actual fruit juice in there as an adjunct. Little slight peppery notes. It's smelling quite gorgeous. Now, I've always found Badgers, you know, Hall and Woodhouse can be slightly hit and miss in that. They can be either really lovely, or occasionally you'll get one of their beers and you'll go, oh, I don't like this, you know. But anyway, let's give it a go. Bottoms up. Cheers. Chin chin. Nostrovia and everything else. Cheers. Lovely glugging beer. Proper glugging beer. Sorry, I've got a little bit of a lid off of another one. That is a proper glugging beer. Get it down ya. Whack, crash, bang, wallop. Yeah, what are we talking with? 4.5. Really sessionable. Nice. A little bit on the gaseous sort of side. You know, when it's like carbonated within an inch of its life and it's like, bah. And it's got that carbonic acid sort of taste. Sulfites are in there, but they're doing a nice job. These kind of little burnt-izing salts and things like that. They're doing a nice job perking those hop flavours up. That's really quite nice. It really is. Delicate little malts. I would imagine like things like Marisotto, and then you've got something like a crystal malt maybe, or something like that in there to perk it with sweetness, because it's quite sweet. But it's not sweet where it's sugared. I don't taste sugar in there. When you get some Bombardier again, when you get like sugars been lobbed in there because there's an insipid malt going on. It tastes kind of quite nice. It tastes, again, quintessentially British. It tastes like that English kind of country garden, kind of cut grass background notes in there. And you can almost taste a little bit of something, you know, Goldings or Fuggles, something like that maybe. You know, sorry, I'm scratching at myself. It is quite warm, and this beard, as much as I kind of love it, it gets a little bit bit warm sometimes. If I trim it off, I look like Mr. Potato Head. I'm not that. Just like a round, like, what's his name? Pilkington, you know. Ricky Gervais's mate. I look like Pilkington, otherwise, look with a round head. So this here kind of like stops me being around it. You didn't know that, did you? Look at that, look. If I pull all that back, look at me, look, rounded. It's terrible, isn't it? I look like a tennis ball. Right, let's get this down. Yeah, orangey notes in there. But yeah, there's little, that's really nice, but it's really weird. It tastes like it's got flavourings in there. But you know what? If it's got flavourings in, it's kind of done in a nice way. And there are beers with flavourings that are not too bad. What was it? One of my guilty secrets, my guilty pleasures, was the Who Garden with that, raspberry or something they put in it? Pink Who Garden. And it was quite nice. But it's like false flavouring in it, you know, but it was quite nice. Some of these cheap kind of the raspberry beers and things like that, they're flavoured up galore, you know. But it kind of does taste as if they've got like a melon flavouring. I had a melon cocktail, a melon liqueur when I was out in Spain. That was flumpence. It was like pennies a bottle. God. Jesus, was it strong. Oh, whoa, who said that, you know? Pardon me. And the kind of the bar geezers that own the bar, see we're a bunch of guys and all that and we're having a drink, they ply us with it. Go on, have another go, fellas. Every time we buy a drink, they ply us with another one. There you go, there's one for you. Oh, I have one yourself, mate. Yeah, lovely, you know. We're spending money galore, you know, and they're plying us with even more. Clever. You know, get us mullered and then throw us out, you know. Anyway, what am I on about? I do apologise, you know, for when I go, I go off on, my brain don't really keep linear anymore, you know. It's just, ever since I had an accident, it just suddenly goes, whew, over there and whew, over there. And it kind of keeps things interesting, I think, you know. It kind of keeps things interesting because you never know where I'm going next, you know, nor do I, You know, suddenly I'll go, what about that? Well, I remember once, then off I'll go again. People go, you was telling the story, Tell. What happened to that? You was telling us about beer as well. And the flavours. I remember I got as far as melon and a bit of apricot in there and peach. Did I say apricot? I didn't, did I? There is that in there. But like those little cordials. Really nice. I like that. I like that a lot. I like that a lot. And I'm hoping not for the bad reasons and that. But do you know what? If whatever it is, it's not... I don't look on it as a cheater if it is. And if it's just using hops and malts, then wow. You know, fair dues to you. I'd love to know if it is just using those. Can't see the, you know, small print's so good. It's tiny. But it doesn't say on there, but then they don't often announce it. But that there is wonderful. It really is. Give it a go. It really is wonderful. And it tastes of the summer. It kind of tastes melons and peaches, and it tastes lovely. It really is. Cheers. Bottoms up. Ooh-ah and everything else. And Dorset, whatever you say. Cheers. Bottoms up. Chin chin. Cheers. With the band to the brain, with the band.